Hi everyone, Tori here today with a process video. So today I'm working on my grandmother's Alzheimer memory book. And if you watched my last video, I shared how I set the book up and did kind of the setup and just an overview of what I'm doing. Today I'm going to be working on the process video of how I kind of put this album together. Now, I debated long and hard about whether I wanted to break this up into like four videos or whether I wanted to just do this all in one. And in the end, just because I have so many videos to catch up on doing voiceovers, it was just easier for me to do it all in one. So I hope you guys will forgive me, and I actually hope that maybe you'll enjoy this longer form video. I'm not sure about you guys, but I actually enjoy a little longer video, especially if it's good content. So hopefully this is good content and I can keep you well informed and interested, and I'm going to tell some stories and have some fun along the way. So hopefully you guys will stick with me as I do this. Just as I'm going here, I did want to mention that I am working on an Alzheimer's memory book for my grandmother. I actually made this back in December, and it was a Christmas present for my grandma. Now, if you have been following me on my channel for a little while, you know that my grandmother has Alzheimer's. And I was doing some research one day when I stumbled upon this like incredible idea on the internet of an Alzheimer's memory book. And this is a book where you make a book for a patient or for a person with Alzheimer's, and you share about their life and about their interests and about who they are. And it's a great memory prompt for them. It's also a great discussion tool for those who meet with them. And it's a great way to help with those memories that are slowly fading that they can't remember. And I was just so incredibly inspired when I saw this idea on the internet that I immediately knew that I wanted to make one for my grandma. And I knew that I could make it for her really simply and easily, and I couldn't wait to get started. So I decided right from the beginning that I wanted to keep it really simple and only use one collection for the whole thing. So as I said in the startup video, I am using the Felicity Jane Emmeline collection. I did order, I think, two extra sets of the pattern paper just because I wanted to make sure that I was going to have enough pattern paper and embellishments and everything for the whole collection. And I'll leave a link for the Emmeline collection below or on my blog as well. I'm not sure if it's still available. You might be able to get the pattern papers and perhaps the stamps still. So my thought process for using only one collection was to keep it really simple. And because of her Alzheimer's, I didn't want to make it overly complicated. I wanted it almost to be like a grown-up adult's picture book or a grown-up adult's memory book kind of thing. And I'm not sure how long she's going to have her language capabilities as well, so I did keep the language fairly simple throughout the book, and I wrote it from her perspective. So in terms of the journaling, I wrote, like, your name is Patricia, and you have, or I have, three grandchildren, or something like that, so that when she was reading it, she could read it from her own perspective, and hopefully it will help her with her memory. So let me dive in, and I'm going to just kind of tell you guys what I'm doing and hopefully share some stories about my precious grandma along the way. On this page, I decided I just wanted to make a little intro page with her name, and this is a more recent photo of her that I'm just going to share with you, and I put her name, Patricia Bissell. I thought about putting her middle name, but I just didn't like the way that it fit, so I ended up taking that off, and I'm not sure it was super relevant anyways, so I think just her full name works just fine, and I am using some of the labels from the cut-apart sheet for embellishments. You know, the crazy thing is that when I showed this album to her, and I do have a clip of me showing it to her, which I'm going to share with you probably in the next video when I do an album walkthrough. When I showed her this photo, she was like, "Who's that?" And I said, "Grandma, that's you." And she's like, "That's not me. That's not what I look like." And I said, "Yeah, Grandma, this is what you look like." And it's so crazy to think that Alzheimer's robs somebody of their short-term memory and then their long-term memory, but also their, like, their frame of reference for time and the passage of time. She didn't even recognize herself in this photo because she doesn't think about herself like that, because in her mind, it's not 2017, it's, I don't know what year it is. She's still pretty cognizant, even though she doesn't know who we are. But I feel like this album hopefully will help and encourage her, and that she can look at it and remember things, or at least be encouraged by the things that I included in this album, even if she can't remember them. So on the accompanying page of that intro page, I decided to just put some basic facts about her, like what her name was when she was born and her birthday. And actually, my grandma was adopted by an amazing Christian couple, which is incredible because she was born in 1934, which was during the Great Depression. And she was basically left at a hospital, and this incredible couple who was actually retired and had three grown boys. One day the mom was in the hospital volunteering or something, and she heard about this baby who had been left behind, and she decided to adopt her. So I just think it's so incredible to hear that kind of story about how my grandmother was adopted in the hospital by this like really loving family who probably didn't have a lot of money or extra money, especially since it was the Great Depression. And they probably were not young and ready to take on a baby because they were retired. But they just really wanted to share love with somebody who kind of was left alone and forgotten. And my grandma tells the story of how she was adopted all the time. So I definitely wanted to include that in this album for her, so that if there ever is a time when she can't remember it anymore, then she'll have that story documented. On the next page, I'm just going to include some other photos and details about her. This is an older photo of her from back before she had Alzheimer's. And I basically, when I was setting up the album, if you watched my setup video, I picked all of the papers and all of the journaling cards before I started decorating, and it just is making this process so much easier because I can kind of just pull out the card and get to it and go with what I have. So I wanted to just add some other journaling on this page about some of the things that she loves. Like, she loves desserts, and she loves dogs, and she loves the color pink, and she she loves music and playing the piano. And I thought that this would be really fun. When I was doing research on Alzheimer's memory books, I discovered that one of the things that can be really beneficial about them is that people who visit this person can actually walk through the book with them. And instead of them asking her questions, which she doesn't know the answer to, and which will end up just frustrating her, they can kind of say, "Hey, oh, you like playing music? What's your favorite song?" Or they can talk to her about the things that are mentioned in the book. And it kind of becomes that great conversation starting place without her having to necessarily remember that she likes playing music, because she might not think of it at the time. But the person can have the discussion with her anyways. So I wanted to definitely start the book with kind of like the beginning of her story. And I don't know a ton of her story, but I do know that she was married to my grandpa, who has passed away now. But I wanted to include him in the book too. She used to remember that she was married. However, I'm not sure if she really remembers that anymore. Maybe if she's really thinks hard, or if she's prompted, or occasionally she will remember it. So I wanted to add that in there. So isn't this precious? This is a photo of my grandma and grandpa on their wedding day. Like, oh, I love this photo. I just want to mention right from the beginning, this is not the original. This is a scan of the original. There's no way I would stick the original in there. I don't know why I wouldn't, but whatever. This is not the original. This is just a scan of it. And I just added some lace and some doily and a piece of vellum just to kind of create a really light, airy effect. And I am adding embellishments to these pages, but I'm keeping them fairly simple just to really make the page go quickly, but to also make it work really well. So my grandpa's name was actually Ross, and he was a fire chief, so that's what you can see his photo there. And it's crazy because you can see on the left-hand side the photo of them on their wedding day, and then in the bottom right you can see a photo of them probably a few months before my grandpa passed away. So they were a lot older. They had been married for almost 50 years, which is crazy. My grandpa passed away in 2013, so I think they were just under 50 years. Just mind-boggling to me. And amazing. Like, yay, grandma and grandpa. So anyways, I was going to tell you this really funny story. My grandpa's name was Ross, and so I put married Ross in 1956 on this page, and I was at the retirement home or at the care facility where my grandma is at, and I was sharing this book with her, and there was this old gentleman who was sitting at the table with her while she was looking at it, and he goes, "That's me." And I said, "No, that's not you." And he's like, "No, that's a photo of me." And I said, "No, sir, that's not a photo of you. That's a photo of my grandpa who passed away a few years ago." And he's like, "That's Ross, isn't it?" And I said, "Yeah, it is." And he goes, "Well, my name's Ross. That's a photo of me." And I was like laughing so hard that this old man who was sitting at this table, who had, like, I don't even know what this guy's name is. I don't even know if his name is actually Ross or not. But he was like adamant that this was a photo of him and my grandma, even though it wasn't, which was kind of funny. But I think in the video that I'm going to share with you of her, like, looking through the book, you'll see this old man saying this about these photos. And I just think, you know, the truth is that, like, he probably has Alzheimer's just like my grandma, and he probably doesn't know what he's talking about. Well, I know he doesn't know what he's talking about. I mean, his name might be Ross, but he just, it made him happy to think that he could be in the scrapbook with her, so I eventually just gave in and said, "Oh, you look so nice in the picture, Ross," which I was just laughing. I was dying laughing after this, and my mom and I were laughing all the way in the car as this guy kept, like, saying that this was a photo of him. But the point of all of that story was to say that, like, sometimes patients with Alzheimer's, like, they do crazy things or they say crazy things or they don't always make sense, or what they say doesn't always, it isn't always accurate. But if they are happy and content, that's what really matters. And when my grandmother first got Alzheimer's, like, this was probably a couple of years in when she was still pretty cognizant, even, and she knew who we were, she just kind of was forgetting little details. She once said to me, "If you don't laugh, you cry." And I think that saying really stood with me and sticks with me even today. I can't imagine what it would be like to live every day with no memory. You have no clue who you are, no clue who anyone is, you don't know where you are, you don't know if you've eaten, you don't know where the washroom is, you don't know anything. And I honestly can't imagine living life like that. And it kind of just makes you want to cry when you just think about life like that. But if you think about it from my grandma's perspective, if you don't laugh, you cry. And I think instead of crying over the fact that my grandma sees a picture of herself and doesn't know that it's her, or instead of crying over the fact that this gentleman who probably also has Alzheimer's thinks that this is a photo of him even though it's not, why not just laugh at the silliness of it and just let him be happy and let him think that this is a photo of him if it makes him happy, and just smile, because if you don't laugh, you cry. So, yeah. Anywho, back to the layout here. I've kind of gotten completely off track. I'm working on the next page, which is kind of another page just about my grandma and grandpa's marriage. And on this page, I've included a photo of my dad and my uncle Jeff. And this photo was taken when they were still young. I think this must have been like when my dad just got married or something, like maybe in his late 20s, I want to say. So that was a long time ago. And on this page, I just put, "You have two sons." And on the label, I just wrote, "This is like Scott and Ross, your husband, and Jeff, your son." And again, like I mentioned, I'm writing it from the perspective of her reading it. Like, "You have two sons." "Oh, I have two sons," she would say. So it's so that when she's reading it, she can think to herself that the conversation is to her. And again, I kept the embellishing pretty simple. I did use a lot of the labels from this cut apart sheet, and I love those 6x12 cut apart sheets from Felicity Jane. I just feel like they're the perfect add-on to a kit, and they give you so many more embellishments. So, yeah. On this page, I wanted to keep it really simple. I just added a couple of labels, and I was trying to think about maybe adding another thing, and the letter stickers that I had grabbed had like a little asterisk on them, so I added that. So the way that I set up the album was I was going to do a couple of pages for each person. So a two-page spread for my dad, my uncle, my aunt, my mom, my sister, my brother, and I. We're kind of, that's what the family entails, or that's what the family is made up of. And my dad is older than my Uncle Jeff, so it probably would have made more sense to put my dad and our family first. But because my Uncle Jeff is married and doesn't have kids, I just thought it would be easier to kind of like put the smaller family first and then the larger family later. I don't know if it makes like complete sense, but the truth is that my grandma probably won't even care. So this is a photo of my Uncle Jeff that I'm going to add on next. And I have a large photo of him, and then I have some small photos. And that's kind of the process that I have for each person. I'll have a one-page spread and then a Project Life type page on the other side. And on the photo, on the one-page side, I'll put, this is Jeff, this is Barb, this is Tori, or whatever. And I'll also put what their relationship to her is. So on this page, I put, this is Jeff. And I'm also going to add something like, he is your son, or this is your son, or this is your younger son. Or something along those lines. Or for myself, I put, this is Tori, your granddaughter, so that she kind of knows who the person in the photo is. Because it's good to put, this is Jeff, but she's not going to know who Jeff is in a little while. Right now, she typically knows who my dad and my uncle are, and those are her sons. But the rest of us, she doesn't know. And I imagine there will be a day when she no longer knows that Jeff and Scott are her sons. So I was kind of making this album for where she is now, but also thinking long term of how can I make an album that will work really well, so that she can kind of see her life and know who she is and more about her. I hope that makes sense. If you guys have any questions at all about this project, please leave them below. The other thing I would love to hear, and you could leave a comment about this in the comment section below, is have you ever made a book or a scrapbook or a box or something for somebody with Alzheimer's? I love the idea of this project. I've been thinking a lot this year, so like at the end of 2016, early 2017, about how I want to make more meaningful projects, projects that have a lot of heart and meaning behind them. I think in the past few years, I've mostly been scrapbooking like just photos that I liked, using the embellishments that I liked, but the pages didn't have a ton of meaning behind them. And this book, because it's for my grandmother with Alzheimer's and really speaks to where she is and what she needs, I feel like it really is a meaningful book. And if you watch my whole series on my XOXO mini album where I wrote love letters to the different people in my life I care about, that was another really meaningful project that I worked on. So, I don't know. I feel like I've gotten to a place where I'm making projects that speak to my heart. And I'm also making projects with items that I love, but not just making them for the fun of making them, but making them with like a heart and a purpose and a passion behind them, which makes me so excited that those are the kind of projects that I want to make. So yeah, this is the next page. This is a page about my Aunt Barb, who's married to my Uncle Jeff. And I have a photo of her. A little photo and a big photo, and I'm just adding those here. And this was such a good project for me to pull out my letter stickers and letter stickers and to really use them. I feel like I never make titles. I don't know what's wrong with me. I'm like cannot make titles. But this one, I think because I had a consistent this is, whatever, it was a lot easier for me to make titles and to add those kind of things to my project. So it worked really well, which I'm so glad. I really enjoy the way that this whole project worked out, and I'm happy with it. I did a little bit of fussy cutting, a little embellishing, and it all worked out like really well in terms of that. So I'm glad. Now, while you're watching this, let me just tell you another fun, adorable story about my grandma, who I love to pieces. She's so beautiful. She's amazing. My grandma, and I've talked about her before on the channel, is probably one of the happiest, most content, loving Alzheimer's patients that I have ever met in my entire life. A lot of the research that I've done shows that sometimes patients with Alzheimer's will get angry or frustrated and upset when they can't remember things. But my grandma, I don't know what it is. There's just something about her that has kept her really happy and content. And you'll ask her how she's doing, and she's like, I don't know, but I think I'm okay. And I know I'm being well taken care of. And she'll play the piano and she'll sing songs. And honestly, the most precious thing is like walking up and down the aisle, walking up and down the halls of the facility where she's at, and like all along the way, whenever we stumble along another patient or another person in there, she'll stop and she'll say, how can I pray for you? And then she'll pray for them, and then she'll keep on walking, and we'll go to her room, and then we'll walk past that person maybe like 10 minutes later, and she'll be like, oh, let me pray for you, and she'll pray for them again. Like, honestly, like, it's so adorable and so precious that she continues to pray for these people, even though she has no idea who they are, and she just prayed for them like 10 minutes ago. Honestly, she's such a sweetheart. And she loves playing the piano, and there's this old piano on the floor where she's at, and she'll go and sit and play. And she says to me, do you think that they mind if I play the piano? And I'm like, no, Grandma, go ahead and play the piano. Like, nobody minds. Everybody loves it. And if she was a bad piano player, people probably would mind, but she's an incredible piano player, so nobody minds at all. So it's precious. She sits down and plays any hymn, and she can't remember anything at all, but she can play any hymn you name, and she can play it from heart. It's like the most incredible thing ever. It's so cool. Oh, she's epic. She's awesome. Okay, so right now I'm working on a page about my dad. So this is Scott, and he is her older son. So I have a photo of him, and then I also have some smaller photos that I'm going to include in there too. And one of the things I did on each page was I tried to include just some random facts or details about the person. So, for example, on my dad's page, I would say, like, Scott is a pastor in Scarborough, and he loves fishing and watching TV and cooking, or whatever. I can't even remember what I said, but something along those lines, so that when she can't remember the things about the person, the book is kind of going to fill in some of those details for her. And if anybody else was reading the book with her, they'd be able to kind of, again, have that conversation with her about, like, oh, your son, he likes fishing. And, like, look at this big fish that he caught. And, oh, this must be a picture of him as a pastor or whatever. So it kind of just opens up that opportunity to have those kind of conversations. One of the things that I tried to do a lot throughout this album was to use up my scraps and to kind of not let anything go to waste. And because I'm using only one collection for the whole entire album, I really wanted to make the album go as far as possible and to stretch it as much as possible. So you'll notice on that page of my dad, I did use a bunch of branding strips, and I do that throughout the album. I think it's a great way to use up your scraps and get even more out of the pages. Because sometimes we just cut those off and then throw them away. But, like, I am such a big believer that we should use our scraps and play with the products that we have and not waste anything. And, yeah, so you can kind of see me doing that here. When I had cut down the 6x8 papers for all of those large 6x8 pages, I was left with this, like, piece that was slightly less than what a 4x6 would be, and so I end up using those as well behind the photos. Like, you can see that big block behind my dad, and it worked really well. So I'm glad how I was able to embellish and add journaling and add details to this and really keep it authentically me, but also make it something that would be really helpful and sweet for her. You know, when as soon as I finished this album and I showed my mom, she was like, oh my goodness, you need to start a business where you make Alzheimer's memory books for other people. And I was like, oh, that would be fun. And she's like, I know people would love it. And I was like, oh, that would be fun. And I would be open to it. But I think the thing is, I really enjoyed making it for my grandma because I knew her and I knew all the details and I knew the family and I knew the kind of things that she would need to hear and the kind of things that make up who she is. I think it would be a lot more difficult to make it for somebody else. But if anybody's interested in me making an Alzheimer's memory book for them, you can message me or leave me a comment and maybe we could figure something out. I don't know. I don't even know if that's a good idea, but my mom had mentioned that I should see if there's anybody interested. And I would be totally okay if you scrap-lifted this entire album because I honestly feel like this project is so meaningful and it's such an incredible gift that you can give to somebody with Alzheimer's and also give to their family. Like, I feel like this is a good gift that I can give to my grandma, but in fact, I'm kind of giving it to my dad and my uncle as well because it's their mom. And I feel like I'm so glad that I did this project and that I stumbled upon these incredible ideas on the internet, on Pinterest, of course. And thank you so much to everybody who gave me ideas. I had written on my Facebook group, Scrap Your Scraps, and on the Scrap Gals podcast Facebook group, saying that I was going to work on this project and wondering if anybody had any ideas. And I got so many incredible ideas. So thank you to everybody who commented and gave me really epic ideas to make this album even better. I really appreciate it. And I'm so glad I was able to make this project for my grandma and to really like be able to incorporate all those ideas and make something that could be really meaningful and truly helpful to her and really encouraging and hopefully lift her heart and lift her spirits. So back to the process video. I keep getting sidetracked, but I feel like that hopefully is okay. It's maybe making this a little bit more interesting. Right now, I'm working on a page for my mom. And so I added a photo of my mom and dad and just had written about how they are married and how Melody, who's my mom, married her older son, Scott, and they've been married for so many years, etc., etc. And on this page, I'm going to add my title of "This is Melody, your daughter-in-law." Now, I love this photo of my mom. I think she looks so regal in this giant hat. You can't see it right now. But there is like this guy who's like semi-shirtless in the back, and it drives me crazy because I'm like, this is such a beautiful photo. And then this like Hawaiian dude with his shirt off is like ruining my picture. I don't know. He's probably not ruining the picture, but I mean, no, he is. He's ruining my picture. And it wasn't even his fault. It's not like he tried to ruin the picture. But this whole entire time I'm making this, I'm thinking, how can I cover this dude up? Because I love this photo. I just don't necessarily love this shirtless dude in the background. It's kind of driving me crazy. So, yep, I'm going to think about that for a little while. As I begin trying to layer up and use some of the scraps for the background and everything. And I was trying to use up some of those shapes that were like slightly smaller than 4x6 behind this photo of my mom. And to also match it with what's on the left-hand side. And I end up going with two of them kind of offset from each other. And then with this horizontal photo. And again, I want to just say, if you want to check out the photos or the details or links to any of the products, I will have those all in the cards of this video as well as on my blog. And if you're still with me, like, holy crap, you're listening to me for a long time talking and I am like so incredibly impressed. So thank you for listening to me talk for a really long time. I feel like I've been talking nonstop for like 30 minutes, and that's because I didn't even take a break. Can you believe I can talk that much? Okay, seriously. Okay, I think what I'm going to do is now that you get kind of the gist of how the album looks and how it all works out, I am going to stop talking for a little bit and play some music and speed it up just a titch more. Hopefully not too fast. I am currently at 4x speed, but I'm going to go just a little bit faster because you can kind of get the idea of how I'm creating the layouts and the pages. I basically have the Project Life page and then the 6x8 page with the larger photo. And I basically do the same thing of this is this person over and over again. So stick with me and I'm going to put you on fast forward and some music for just a little bit. Actually, I found a really awesome clip of my grandma singing and playing the piano, and I wanted to share that with you. Nothing but the blood.
He lives.